Hi everyone, our topic is deformation in porphyry regions on Qinghai Tibet Plateau observed by INSAR methods. General variations of hydrothermal conditions near the top of porphyry soil or frets, bring substance or uplift to surface, affected by the increasing mean annual ground temperature over the past several decades. Porphyry degradation is generally occurring on Côte P. In the meanwhile, lake outburst events are increasing on Côte P. For example, the outburst of high water Dolac Lake in the heartland of Côte P make plenty of water flooded downstream from Dolac Lake into Kusa Lake, Hiding Lower Lake, and Salt Lake. As the tail water lake of this hydronic collection, Salt Lake experienced a significant expansion since 2011. We employed two spatial INSAR analysis methods, stems and spats, to retrieve long-term surface deformation in typical porphyry regions on Côte P, and compared possible external conditions such as temperature precipitation and lake outburst, which could lead permafrost degradation. For case study 1, the STEMS method was applied in the Wudaonliang region using Sample 1 images spanning from March 2017 to June 2018. For case study 2, the Google Earth Engine platform was employed to extract the Salt Lake boundary from January 2000 to September 2019 at monthly scale. Meanwhile, surrounding lake surface deformation before and after the outburst of the Lake Lake was retrieved by applying the sparse method on NSAT from 2003 to 2010 and Sample 1 from 2014 to 2019. Here are deformation results for case study 1, which reveal significant seasonal changes of permafrost in a freeze thaw cycle. 6 PS points along the Qinghai Tibet Railway are selected, and the overall trends are thawing during April and September and thawing from September to April in the next year. Compared with in-situ temperature, we found that there are lagging days between maximum before deformation and temperature. The lagging days of 53 in thawing period is longer than those of 34 days in the freezing period. For case study 2, the area of Salt Lake had increased 5.35 times in September 2019 than that in January 2000. Meanwhile, the distance from the lake boundary to the Qinghai Tibet Railway was significantly reduced from approximately 14 to 8 km. For surface deformation results surrounding Salt Lake, both ascending and descending outcomes, more apparent substance can be observed from Sentinel-1 than MSAT. The larger substance after the lake outburst provides an evidence that the outburst of a headwater lake may significantly accelerate the permafrost degradation surrounding the tailwater lake. Temperature and precipitation are discussed as factors accelerating permafrost degradation. When the cumulative substance is found more evident after the outburst, however, the trends of temperature are decreasing. The greater annual precipitation didn't trigger a greater degree of surface deformation in the permafrost regions around the lake. The comparison could indicate that temperature and the precipitation have limited effects on the accelerated degradation of permafrost. In the study, two multi-temporal INSAR methods have been successfully applied in monitoring permafrost surface deformation on Côte P. Multi-source satellites and ground in-situ data will be used in different regions to further improve the methodology. That's all. Thanks for your attention.